Today we're wrapping up the series called The Last Mile. The last mile being the bringing of this ideas of spirituality and the thoughts around being a follower or a seeker, bringing it all the way in, that last mile, into our hearts and into our minds.
As we look inward, we bring comfort and caring
to the parts of us who are hurt or wounded inside, that cause us quite often to be the one that is less caring, less loving, less beautiful than we'd like. And so we bring love to the situation rather than judgment.
I
really hope that many of us are moving away from a judgmental way of treating our differences and moving into a state of understanding as the basis of communal relationships. And one of the communities, of course, that we're most interested in this series is the internal community. So we bring understanding rather than judgment about the parts of ourselves, many of which we have been able to keep hidden from others, but which we know are there. And so we're looking for acceptance and understanding. And now I'd like to add one more thing, which is this idea of surrender. Now, when you get to surrender, we don't ask you to surrender to any aspect of yourself. In this sense, we only ask you to surrender to your higher aspect, or that higher aspect to the part where it connects with all it is. In other words, in simpler language, we ask you to surrender to the divine, to God, to the universe as it
is. And
so when we pray and we open to the divine, when we essentially surrender into the wisdom and the process that the divine sets forth, this, we feel a sense of comfort and relax. And as we relax, we begin to recognize possibilities, move with more grace, speak with more kindness, act in ways that we're more happy about because we're not really doing it all ourselves. We are essentially saying, God, help me. Do for me what I don't know how to do for myself right now. I'm willing to be a partner in this, but I need help. So when you ask, it's really wise to also surrender the shape and the form and the timing of when it will happen, and just let it happen according to the divine will. And in so doing, just let your mind relax a little bit. You have done your best. You've given it your best thoughts, your best efforts, and now you can release and let it over to someone else.
That the divine
cradle of loving acceptance can be one of the goals of this experience of being in social distancing, and
perhaps we
can
come to
it much more quickly if we ask the divine to help us come to love and acceptance. Our asks don't have to just simply be about comfort or ease or prosperity or health, but our ask can be on transformation, that we are transformed by this moment and that we do it with ease and grace. Now, if you're able to do the surrender, if you're able to take what life is giving to you with a sense of, this is for my betterment, all things are happening to me for my good, that is a form of surrender itself. It isn't saying you know better than the universe what should be happening right now. It is saying, I deeply trust that all things are working out and will work out well for me. That this is the nature of things, that though you may not understand it, and some of it may be surprising, and sometimes because our ego's involved, it may be hurtful even, but all things are working for our own good. And so let us invoke this idea that we are partners with the divine in all that is happening right now. We're not the victims and we are not simply at effect, but we're partnering. And in partnering now, we are joining with and we're saying yes. As we say yes, so I think we lay down a large part of our burden. And we seek the good inside.
We
seek to find good in what's happening here. And as it says in the scriptures, when you seek the kingdom first, then all the other things will be added to you. And so I believe if we will seek to partner with the divine in this process and to look for the good inside it, we will find it.